Hello everyone, welcome back to Radio Intimate Easy, where it is taught to be free with everyday new cases which are carefully selected and of course short videos. Let's get started. So, today our case is a 2-year-old boy presented with pain and swelling of left knee area. And these are the films. So now, observe carefully and try to write down your findings in a paper. In this way, you can acquire more benefit from our video. Now let's discuss findings, DDs, diagnosis and key points. So after analyzing your findings, I think now you have come to a diagnosis. So first discuss what are your findings. Basically, there are 4 main findings in these films. We will discuss them one by one. So I'll take a pointer so you can see it clearly. So in this film, you can see there is a longitudinally oriented and well-defined ovoid lucency is located eccentrically in the medial distal metaphysis of the left femur. Please be specific when you present or write your findings because it is very important in your examination purposes to impress your examiners. After all, we all do this for our exams, right? And then in this film, you can see the medial cortex is absent, and when you carefully observe, there is a small extraosseous component can be seen. And at the inferior margin, the cortex is undercut by the lesion, but there is no visible periosteal reaction is seen. And here, the zone of transition is narrow and fairly well defined. When you zoom it, you can clearly identify these features. So try to identify all these features and come to a diagnosis or differential diagnosis. So what are your differential diagnoses? It can be either an osteosarcoma, because this is a 2-year-old boy and it is a possibility. And of course it can be an Ewing sarcoma too. Eosinophilic granuloma is another possibility, and non-ossifying fibroma is another possibility, and finally it can be a chondromyxoid fibroma. So the diagnosis here is eosinophilic granuloma in the distal femur of a 2-year-old child. Please be remember to present your full diagnosis or the complete diagnosis when you present, because it is very important in your exams. Now let's discuss key points about eosinophilic granuloma. It is uncommon and represents the localized form of Langerhans cell histiocytosis. It mainly affects children and young adults. It can be either unifocal or multifocal. And skull, pelvis, ribs or diaphysis of long bones are most commonly affected. And finally, the imaging appearances are variable, so these lesions may show aggressive features. So this is the end of the today's video. Thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe, and don't forget to share with your friends. Keep in touch for our next videos. Thank you.